Hello, I'm Dr. Garry Ho, one of the sports medicine physicians here at OrthoVirginia. I'd like to talk to you today a little bit about a condition that is really problematic to our patients and kind of an interesting one from a doctor's perspective. It's a condition called frozen shoulder, also known as adhesive capsulitis. It has a few other names as well, but those are probably the two most common names attributed to it. And it's a very peculiar condition. It's a condition where the shoulder gets painful and stiff for no other apparent reason. There are several theories as to what causes it, but nobody really knows what causes it. But needless to say, people with frozen shoulder go through this unhappy sort of experience where they first start off with a painful shoulder, and then it starts to get stiff and painful at the same time. And then it reaches this kind of maximum of dysfunction where the shoulder's really, really stiff and they can't move their shoulder all the way. They can't really put the cup on the shelf or anything like that. And it's a real problematic problem. The good news is that by definition, frozen shoulders or adhesive capsulitis go away on their own. The bad news is it can take up to 3 years for it to go away on its own. So that's why we treat it. Several different ways of treating it. From a non-surgical perspective, we treat it with physical therapy and exercises, stretching exercises. And then at the far end of the other spectrum, you have surgery. But thankfully today, we've got multiple options in the middle, which are procedures that are not surgery, but with physical therapy and other rehabilitative exercises can help drive the recovery to push you through that those different stages and get you to resolve your frozen shoulder much sooner than the 3 years that you would have to otherwise wait. We get results in a matter of weeks to months, and some more stubborn cases may take a little longer than a few weeks, but we will treat every patient individually to try to get them to recover as soon as possible. So what are some of those treatments in between? There are certain ultrasound-guided injections that we could do. You could inject the joint with steroids, and you can also do what's called a hydroplasty or hydrodistension. To understand what that is, it's first to understand what a frozen shoulder is. You see, in a frozen shoulder, you have your ball socket joint, which is your shoulder joint, okay? And the ball socket joint is surrounded by a saran wrap kind of like covering we call the joint capsule. And normally that joint capsule is very baggy and loose. That allows you to move your arm fully, just like baggy pants will allow you to move your knees and your hips very fully. But in a frozen shoulder, that joint capsule gets thickened, inflamed, and shrunken. Now you've got a very tight and thickened covering around the joint, which prevents the shoulder from moving all the way. So what we try to do with both the exercises to stretch it is to kind of loosen that capsule up again to help get it, to encourage that recovery back to its normal loose configuration. So what we do with the hydroplasty or the hydrodistension of the joint is that we first block the nerve that goes to about 60% of the joint, okay, to basically give you some numbing. And then what we do is with the ultrasound, we precisely place a needle inside the joint and we inject fluid in there, usually a combination of anesthetic and some IV fluids and maybe some corticosteroid to slowly stretch the capsule. And because we've put some numbing medicine in there and we numb the nerve, it's fairly well tolerated. And we try to give that capsule, encourage it to stretch back out. Sometimes people need to have repeated treatments, but that is a nice alternative to what used to be a surgical problem that people did not get better fast enough with rehab and PT. So hopefully you've learned a little bit about frozen shoulder adhesive capsulitis here at OrthoVirginia. You have a multi-specialty team between non-operative physicians like myself in sports medicine and some of the world's best surgeons as well, where we can meet your needs in the full spectrum of care for a lot of conditions, including adhesive capsulitis or frozen shoulder. So come in and see us. We're excited to be here. Nice to see you.